So I'm all 3 minutes from him.
I fully agree with you. I think that it's a wonderful stimulating session for us. And started with Zen, data-driven healthcare system. Very good presentation. There will be some quality issues, and there are, of course, issues of magnitude. Like in India and China, we have not only magnitude, we have numbers, we have varieties coming from a community-driven healthcare system to a national kind of a system.
Yeah.
It has a multi-layer system within the systems. In fact, like for example, in India, we go district level as three systems. So has the state level as three systems. And again, we have a national level, we have another regional system and the federal system. So we have 8 to 9 layers actually to be integrated into one system. And your point was well taken. Personal interests, how will they be solved? Because they are healthcare systems now been taken into multimodal. Government, private partner, and private. Three have three interests, different interests, and that is where you have a integration of all healthcare system or health information system into one. It becomes a huge challenge.
Yes.
And that is where we have, I think your researches will take us further into that. And probably you can involve some other examples around the world to make it a very perfect kind of system. But congratulations, a very good work that you did. Zoe, this presentation was National E-Government Plan. You have taken all the information, I think, from the secondary sources of the government
that's
of India.
True, true,
yeah. And little old, that too. Because nationally, as you mentioned, it was made in 2006, and a lot of headway has been made after that. And a lot of new ideas have already been taken up by the government of India and different state governments. And different state governments in the different layer of the governance that they have evolved their own plans. Like example, now it is mandatory to have an e-tender or any purchase beyond 1 million rupees. You have a national mandate that you cannot do it otherwise. You have to go for e-tender. So it becomes an open, big and transparent system. And participatory, of course. The government of India has also created what you call as e-market, government e-market. All the purchases from government e-market are exempt from tendering requirements. So you can go there, you have a prepay. That is also important. You have to pay before you purchase. So the hassles of lenient payments are also taken care of. Digital India initiative has already been taken, I believe. You must have noted
that. The
Kisan health card, Kisan soil card, the Bheem-based, app-based approaches. They have already been taken. And direct subsidy transfer. This is one of the major work that India has done now. That all subsidies given to the poor people are transferred to their national accounts directly now.
Which with the pension and also.
That is something that has changed
pensions
the whole
also, and all age pension, all
all benefits.
LPG gas cylinder subsidies.
Subsidies and pensions, they are all transferred to the Indian accounts. For all middlemen.
That's great because in the United States, it's the middlemen.
All of these facing the problem.
Yeah, it's
great. And how politically could you get that done?
And it has done wonderful because the maximum number of beneficiaries are on that side. The poverty situation in India makes the numbers terrible to the people who have the political system. And then, of course, the government of India has also mandated that all the money given to individual or government to government or on the digital platform. No cash transfer, no checks, no drafts. So all digitally transferred now. That has also been taken care of. I hope you will see in future papers that you take those. Because technology necessarily doesn't produce change. The users change. Anurag, you already got compliments from Stanton. From I think you feared him most. So you got the first. I think because Stanton missed most of the points because he did not have the idea of India. I have. So, keep the compliments on the standard, but you need to understand many more things. Peak hour problems in India is different from peak hour problems in many other countries. We
because the peak in India cannot be calculated on day-to-day basis. You have plenty of fairs and festivals that created peak. And then every now and then you have a problem because the, then the millions of people turn suddenly. Because the fairs and festivals attract people, they go back home. And that creates a problem in Indian transport systems, whatever size you may have. Because that peak is not calculated on the average basis. It is unique. Like example, festival Diwali or Holi or Eid or Moharram, they will attract people like it. Chhat, for example. And then you also have a problem. If there is a chhat, a program called chhat fair, people will go towards Bihar. That is one state of India. It is attracted most of them because the pressure will be on that state. It's a local festival of that state.
From western to eastern part of
India. So if you have Onam, people will go to South India. That is a typical unique problem of India which cannot be calculated on peak basis, which is derived in western systems. You have to evolve your own plan because of this. Number two, of course, that the mobility on the basis of metro. We have adopted a unique plan of metro. We have not gone underground. All our metro, in fact, 80% of the metro in India is not underground. That was created, that was a brilliant idea of Metro Man of India, or the most awarded person, is that you get on the
elevated.
Yeah. Because the cost difference between elevated route and underground is 5 times.
Yeah.
It costs 200 crores per kilometer if you go elevated. That was 1,000 crore per kilometer if you go underground. So we went overground and wherever need, on the surface, underground as well as overground. Because the busiest thoroughfares, it is underground. So that doesn't disturb the city, especially busy areas. And the moment you are out of it, you are overground. So that way he has created and reduced the
financial.
Third thing that you were discussed was the private metro systems have already failed. Before launch, Mumbai Metro has failed because it was run by a private player. He wants to earn profit, and that is not an issue.
Your pricing
up, the users are down, and it becomes unviable. The monorail is already failed because of the cost. Because the private players cannot run public systems. That is a very different proposition. And that is why Sridhar created a model for the rest of the country to follow. Because it has says the government's stakes have to be on the higher side. It's only the government which can have patience of learning over the year. And that is how Delhi Metro is not only the busiest in India, but also the most profitable. But Hyderabad, Bangalore, Jaipur, they are all failing because of the private players. So we have to have this the clarity. Road accident, of course, you have a dubious distinction, but road accidents in India, again, have to be seen from Indian perspective. It's not because of the number of vehicles, but because your licensing system, driving license system, is easiest in the world.
And you get it very easy.
You can now cannot get in home because you have to get photograph the machine. Otherwise, it is as easy as you can think of.
Yeah.
And that is creating the problem. People are not understanding the responsibility. While driving license is a responsibility to drive, not an authority to drive. And that is not taught in India, and that is how the accidents got up.
True.
People know only that accelerator and steering, nothing else. No brakes.
And responsibility of
and
the driver. Yeah.
That is not app-based. That has to be solved at the level of. So I was saying that technology, sociology and psychology all have to be imbibed into one to become public administration.
Yes.
And that is where the problems are. India is going for a bullet train. Learning from China, that we must also have bullet trains, and Japan is helping in that.
Yeah.
But there are two fears. The cost, I think more than 30,000 crores.
Yeah.
And then the fears. Will be viable.
And
China is also struggling to find that viability point. That the trains are fastest probably in the world, fair enough. But the cost is also very high. So the occupancy is low.
And the maintenance. In Washington, our metro is getting worse and worse because they were happy to build big stations and beautiful stations, but nobody's happy to pay for maintenance.
And the final paper, of course, is a wonderful emergency management system. I share the fear. Technology and psychology.
Yeah, no problem. Whatever.
The moment you say emergency that side, how will I behave?
Yeah.
Google will say me go left. Okay. My panic sense says go right.
Create a problem,
which will create further emergency. Mm-hmm. You know, second layer of emergency. Mm-hmm. Because the panic in an emergency situation is something that can be handled through psychology, not technology. Mm-hmm. And then we have to make them understand each other. You know, how to handle technology during the time of crisis and how to use technology without a crisis. The driverless cars are also making accidents because, you know, the perfection of technology cannot be taken for granted. And that too under emergency situation. An emergency could be of two kinds. Natural emergency, as you mentioned, and the emergency created by technology. For a glitch, for a snag, for a bug. I was going through a presentation that the world came to a nuclear war, very close to nuclear war, 30 times. And all 30 times because of the computer glitch. Not a single time it was a reality. The sensors make that something they spotted and feared that, and they created a signal, emergency signal. And they were actually, it is only because of the second layer of, you know, confirmation. Then they realized that it was not going to be a war. So technology created crisis. It is good that you must attend, work on it. It is a very interesting, fascinating, and fantastic idea. You must work. You go into some kind of emergency also. Let's find out. Let's find out. Just to, you know, you have. I think going into a driverless kind of system or system. Maybe you can have a multimodal system also. You know, the cars that can travel on. In a little bit of air also, in water also, working on it, that will reduce emergency may or maybe increase emergency. That is another matter. But all in all, I think very good session, and we have learned the use of technology, we have to understand the psychology, and we have to understand the social systems within the systems to make fully a better operational systems of this. What we call as IT systems that we can learn lessons from. Thank you, Santan, and thank you, the chair. We made the sessions within the time.